They're often the first to arrive when you need help. Police officers, they spend hours on the road responding to emergencies, but sometimes they're actually the ones in need. In 2012, more than 800 police vehicles were involved in crashes, and that's just in North Carolina. But as CBS North Carolina's Maggie Newland shows us, local researchers are working to make the roads safer while officers are working behind the wheel.
They're one of a police officer's most important tools.
To ask anybody if your computer's down, you can't work.
Instructions for officers constantly come through their in-car computers. It's how they learn where to go, who needs help, or whether a situation could put them in danger.
That's how we look up reports. It's how we do reports. Everything is done over the computer.
The more information we have before we get to a scene, the better we are equipped to handle whatever the problem is.
Cary Police Chief Tony Godwin learned early on the benefit of having a computer in his patrol car. He was one of the first officers in the state to have one back in the 90s. And although police say these computers provide information they need to help keep them and others safe, researchers with NC State's Industrial and Systems Engineering Department say they could also put officers and drivers at risk. Cite studies from across the country that found driver distraction to be a primary cause of emergency vehicle crashes.
We are trying to make the job safer and make the driving task safer for the officers and, of course, normal drivers on road.
Miriam Zahabi is researching ways to make it easier for officers to use their computers while on the road. Using this simulator, she and her fellow researchers analyze how officers use their computers. They can determine exactly where someone's eyes are looking and for how long, and they can see how driving is affected. Miss a hazard and there are consequences.
Oh, she crashed.
Cary police officers participated in the research, although Cary's chief emphasizes it's against department policy for officers to actually use their computers while driving a moving car.
As everybody that has a cell phone knows, it is very, very difficult to drive and look at a screen.
But researchers believe the in-car computers can be made more user-friendly for officers. Currently, there's a lot of text on the screen.
It's a couple of different pages of narrative, and the officer has to scroll through different pages and look for the information that he's trying to get.
We can present the information in a way that's less demanding for the officers. So we provide a summary page for them. We provide a navigation tool to go through different pages of information.
We've added some features to it, shifting from text-based presentation of information to using tables and graphics.
Although the study isn't finished yet, Chief Godwin says he found a big difference when using the new layout.
It was easier to get to the screen that you needed, and then when that information came back out, it was more readily apparent on the screen. It wasn't multiple pages of information that you had to get down to.
And the researchers say they noticed changes too.
Better lane maintenance, better speed control, more eye time on road. So yeah, we've seen some really quite good results with just simple changes that the manufacturers could make. So
anything that we can do to improve the process, improve the efficiency, and make it safer for the officer, make it safer for the general motor public, that's always a good thing.
Maggie Newland, CBS North Carolina.
This NC State study is the first of its kind to analyze the interface of the in-car computer to make it safer and more user-friendly. A number of studies from other states, however, show that driver distraction does play a role in emergency vehicle crashes.